Hey guys, it's Becky here and welcome back to my channel. So today is the International Tea Day, which makes me really happy because once again I can talk about books and tea together. So today I decided to use this opportunity and speak a little bit more about books where the tea is a very important part of the whole story. And I haven't read these books, I have them in my TBR library, but I still thought it might be interesting if I will mention them and introduce the stories to you, and maybe it will give you a chance to have a new book you can add to your TBR library as well. Oh, and also look at this. I got a new tea mug, but I mean, can you see this? This is so big, I could literally put my head into that when I'm drinking. Okay, anyway, back to the books. So the first book I would like to talk to you about is the book called The Tea Girl of Hummingbird Lane by Lisa C. This book is a historical fiction and it's set in China. The main character is Lian, who is growing up with her family in a very small village, and their life is pretty much surrounded around farming and tea. One day a stranger comes to the village and he is looking for some special or rare kind of tea. And even though the village where she grew up is very small, she got very well educated, so she works as a translator between the men and also the rest of the village. And as the time passes, Lian finds herself pregnant, but it's outside of the marriage. So she decides to leave the baby girl in the nearest city, only with a tea cake wrapped in the blanket. Mother and daughter are going separated ways, and even though the little girl, which is called Haley, will get adopted by a Californian family and is surrounded by love and gets a good education, slowly she starts to be curious about what truly happened, where is she coming from, and her origins. And meanwhile, also Lian starts to long for her daughter. So I guess that the book is about these two characters trying to find the way back to each other, and apparently, according to description, tea should be the very important part in this process because tea was shaping their family lives for generations. So I really like this book, I already bought it and have it on my phone and I cannot wait to read this, but now I'm reading two books in one time, which I never do usually. I usually read only one book at a time, I don't know what happened, but once I finish these books I'm immediately jumping to this one. So hopefully I'll manage to get it into my wrap-up video at the end of June. So the book number two is called Teatime for the Firefly by Shona Patel. This book is set in India and the main character is Laila, who was born under the unlucky star, but despite that her grandfather raised her to be very independent and also well educated. When she gets married, her life takes her to Assam, but she's quite struggling to find her place in the new society because these tea plantations are owned by British efficiency, and Laila is kind of struggling to get along with the British wives, and also servants are not very nice to her, so it takes her some time to get used to the new lifestyle. But as the time progresses and she is happily married with her husband and they are overlooking the tea plantation, things slowly seems that they might be turning into better direction. However, in that moment, India needs to face the sweeping changes of upcoming World War II. So the third book is The Memory of Water by Emi Itaranta. It's a science fiction book, and let me tell you that by all means, I am really not a fan of science fiction. I read maybe two or three books. Maybe one. I'm not sure, but science fiction is really not something that I would be particularly interested in or I would be reading very much, but this book seems to be very interesting to me because apparently in this book, global warming is slowly destroying the whole planet, which is not something we are far away from, so it might not be sci-fi at all at the end. But anyway, back to the book itself. So the global warming is destroying the whole planet and water becomes a very rare thing because there is not enough of it for everyone. China is ruling the whole Europe and also Scandinavian Union. There up in the north, 17-year-old Noria is training to become a tea master as her father. Tea masters are very important because they know the secret places where the water is still hidden and they can provide them for the whole village. When Noria's father died, the water becomes even more rare. So at this point, Noria needs to decide what is she gonna do with her life. Is she going to continue to become a tea master and face some difficult and struggles and obstacles and dangerous challenges, or is she going to choose the peaceful life without not becoming a tea master? So I really like this book, and I mean, it might be a sci-fi, but not very much. Because global warming is a real thing, as we all know, so I definitely want to read this. So another book I would like to introduce to you is the book called Vanessa's Use Magical Paris Tea Shop by Rosal Lim. The main character in this story is called Vanessa, and she always had a special gift because she was able to read people's fortune from the bottom of their tea mugs. But she was never really happy with this gift, and so she switched to the coffee, which is actually really cute. But her romance life was also never very successful, and so her parents decided to match her with a matchmaker and get her appointment there, which I really don't know why should parents do stuff like this, but anyway, the day before she's supposed to have the appointment, she accidentally sees her own fortune in the T-Mac, which is dying in traffic accident. So she decides that until that happens, she really wants to enjoy her life, and so she leaves to the Paris to her aunt, where she works with her in her antique Parisian tea shop, which I absolutely adore. And there she decides to try her own matchmaking skills by trying to reconnect her aunt with her lost love. Okay, moving on to another book I would like to introduce to you, and this book is called The Tanglewood Tea Shop by Lilac Mills. In this book we meet Stevie, who works as a patisserie chef, but she feels really stuck with her life. Her aunt died, she lost her job, and also the love of her life walked away. So she really doesn't know where to go on next with her life, until the point when she is called to the solicitor's office to find out that her aunt left her a massive amount of money. So Stevie decides to do something with her life, and she buys a little tea shop in the small village called Tanglewood. But the life there is not that idyllic as she would imagine, because apparently people there are not very nice, and it seems that they're kind of like fighting the whole sugar, like no sugar thank you. So it reminds me a little bit like a chocolate film. If you haven't seen it, really check it. So Stevie is really struggling to find her place in this new community, and it seems like it's not the best idea to sell cakes and tea to people who really doesn't like sugar, so she's considering maybe leaving, until the point when Nico, who I guess is some random nice handsome guy, will appear, and then she will have a chance to reconsider her decision and maybe stay in the village anyway. So I'm not particularly driven to this story, but I think it seems like a nice romance which I could live in summer in the garden, so I might give it a shot. So I must say I'm very excited about this upcoming thing I'm going to introduce to you, because it's not a single book, but it's also a book series. And it's called A Tea Shop Mystery Series by Laura Child. There are 24 books which were published between 2001 and 2021. The main character is Theodosia Browning, who is owning a Charleston Indigo tea shop. And people love her because of her personality and also hospitality skills, but it seems that she cannot do a single catering without stumbling on a corpse. So meanwhile she is serving tea and cakes, she is also solving murder mysteries. I mean, I love it. I love it. Another book I would like to introduce to you is the book called The Tea Planter's Wife by Dina Jefferies. This book is set in 1920, and we meet young Gwendolyn, who was married when she was 19. She was married to this charming and nice widower, and she leaves to the tea plantations with him, where she's determined to become a good wife and mother. But the life there is really something different from what she imagined, because she really struggles to find her place in the new community, and also people there are really resentful, so she feels quite lonely all the time. And also it seems like the past is still kind of getting to her all the time, but her husband is not willing to talk about it. When she finally finds her feet in the new place, it seems like a disaster strikes and she needs to face the terrible truth, and it seems like the whole place and also her husband is keeping a secret from her, and that also includes what really happened to his first wife. I'm really interested to read this story because 1920s is one of my most favorite periods to read about, and also I would really like to know whether the story is quite similar or even the same as Rebecca by Daphne du Maurier, because the premise of the story, especially with the wife, seems to be quite similar, so I would really like to know whether this is something different and new, or if it is the same premise basically, because I do love Daphne du Maurier, so I really want to know what is this book about. So I think these are the all fictional books I wanted to talk about, and oh yeah, I will quickly mention Alice in Wonderland, which I'm not going to introduce to you because obviously everyone knows what is the story about, but there is amazing tea party with Mad Hatter and Alice and the Mouse, so watch the film, read the book, it's absolutely amazing and you cannot miss it when it's World Tea Day. So yeah, that's all the fictional books I wanted to mention right now, and now I'm going to place on the screen the list of the non-fictional books which you could be interested in as well, because these books are talking pretty much about the brewing tea, the history of tea, how to drink tea and how to make tea properly, so you can have a look at it and see if there is something of your interest. So thank you very much for joining me for today's video. I hope that you enjoyed it and also that there is at least one book you liked or was interesting for you so you can read it in the future. And now I think I'll go and make another cup of tea because I already finished this one here. So I'm gonna go, and you have a lovely day and have a cup of tea as well. Bye!